Hey there, Deep Thinker. Today I want to talk about how I've designed my knowledge map in Heptabase. Right, so the first thing that I want to address or talk about is what is the map in Heptabase? Well, it's a visual way to lay out your ideas and your thoughts. The founder of Heptabase actually said it this way: the principle of thinking and creating is visual. To clarify our thinking, we often have to visualize the big picture of our ideas. Moving and reorganizing information on visual space is a critical process to augment thinking. In Heptabase, the meta app responsible for this task is called Map. So we see here, a big purpose of the map is to clarify our thinking and augment or increase our thinking, right? And the best way to do that is visually. Seeing the information connected with lines and grouped in sections can help our brains make stronger connections between our ideas. Now on the map, the only thing that you can do is add a whiteboard. It's not a place for cards or text elements and sections and the connection lines. Just as a geographical map reveals where you are, a knowledge map reveals who you are. I want to pause just for a moment here and give you a free gift for hanging out with me today. This is a short PDF guide on how to get insights from the nonfiction books that you read and that you love into your PKM system. By the end of this guide, you'll have a simple system for highlighting your books, a mindful approach for adding content to your PKM system or PKM notes app, a process for creating building blocks of knowledge for the future, and then a simple tip for making more connections between your notes. The link to the free guide is in the description below. All right, so when we go into the map, you can see I've got about 9 whiteboards here. The first one that I want to start with is this whiteboard titled God Notes, right? These are insights that I get while I'm studying scripture. Now, I do have some sub-whiteboards in here because those topics or books warranted a new whiteboard with the amount of information. So, for example, if I dive into Joseph here, you can see this is a massive section, and then I have sections within this section right here. And each of these sections are usually chapters of a book, and so I will, or even part of a chapter of a book, maybe even a section of a chapter, depending on the length of the chapter. So these whiteboards, they contain the source, which is the Bible, along with my insights tucked inside the sections. So this is the actual source text, and then I have arrows connecting thoughts, ideas, insights, and then I can link to other sections, right? So I can jump over to this section right here. It takes you right to it, which is very nice. And then I have another one right here where I actually can jump into a section of another whiteboard. If I click on this, it takes me into a whole other whiteboard titled Jacob, and it takes me right to this section where I can get context of the ideas. Now, these other whiteboards that I have these all these ones that start with a life of creating, a life well lived, a life of learning, a life of with, and then there's this wisdom one right here. These are my value whiteboards. You may be asking, why values? Well, I like to collect ideas based on what I value because it helps me filter the noise to only focus on the sounds that resonate, right? In this case, it's my life values. So I found that the quality of the ideas that I take in has improved by using values as a collection filter, if you want to call it that. So for example, a life of creating right here. If I go into this whiteboard, at the very top level, it's a life of creating. And then I have sections marked off right here that are grouping some cards And then the title of the section is kind of the idea, the main idea, or the topic. So I have basically, I use sections here to group the notes into niche areas within the value, right? The creator's mindset. And then within a section like this, I have the cards, which could be a quote, could be thoughts, could be ideas. It's all of the above. And they are put in there. I could even put highlights. I have highlights from books. This is all from, well, it's from a couple different books. These are all highlights related to the partnership of wisdom and creativity, right? And so it's wrapped in a section so I can easily see what these are related to and what they're about, and how they work together, right? And I'll often create a section because I see a connection between two notes, rather than starting with a section and then trying to fit ideas in there, right? So if you'll notice on the right-hand side over here, I have quite a few ideas. It's just a section called note cards. And these are note cards that I need to go through and I need to try to put into either an existing section, and I can make copies of the cards too, right? There's no wrong way to do that, but I could also create a new section if I find that at least two cards are grouped together. When grouped together, they form this new idea or this new niche topic, or captain idea or something like that, that's within the realm of a life of creating. All right, next up is the workbench. The workbench right here. Okay, so if I click into this, this is actually a single whiteboard that houses the projects that I'm working on or ideas that I'm pondering. There isn't like much in the way of organization in this space. I simply just use sections to group ideas that I'm thinking about. For example, like I have a pondering section, literally called pondering. And these are ideas that I have taken down. Most of these are actually from a conference that I recently attended on homeschooling. But I want to think about these further because they really, really stood out to me. And so I have these in the workbench, right? The workbench is where I am working. Things are being made and things are being worked on and worked through. I also use sections when I'm making sense of an idea, right? So for example, this is a recent one. I've been trying to study a chapter in the book Genesis with Cain and Abel. Again, this is the source text here. Let me zoom in a little bit. A source text with the reference on where it's at and all that. And then I have lines everywhere, spaghetti noodles, connecting various insights and thoughts and ideas related to this portion of the source text, right? Same thing over here. And it's all housed in a section titled Genesis 4, Cain and Abel. And things can be linked to the section, like I mentioned earlier in this video, which is something that's really powerful for me, at least, because it allows me to see the context of the idea that I connected to, which is really nice. Okay, let me jump back out, and I want to talk about meaningful moments here. So meaningful moments for me are moments that I like to write down during the day that, you know, when I look back at them, they'll make me smile, make me laugh, or make me cry, or all three. It's a space to remember the good and the beautiful things in my life, right? I think it's so important for us to have something like that, not only to collect knowledge that's practical and all that stuff, but to collect things that remind us of how good life can be and how grateful we can be because we have amazing things that are in our life, right? And so this is a way for me to kind of jump back in time and remember that there are good things happening and have happened and will happen in my life. Again, I've used sections here to block these off. I have a personal section of just things that I've accomplished, abundance to remind me of that I live in, you know, in abundance and not scarcity, that there's more than enough. A keep going section, encouragement from you guys, actually, on comments that you make on YouTube or things that I hear from a friend or whatever on things that I may be particularly uniquely gifted at. It's just a reminder that I need to keep going. I can keep creating, keep making things for people and adding value. And then finally, I have a family one where there's just a bunch of moments of our family and things that probably only our family would laugh at, but that's okay. So there's meaningful moments. And finally, weekly reviews. So weekly reviews right now is, I have it another whiteboard within this. So this is a sub whiteboard titled 2024 inside of the weekly reviews whiteboard. And when I go into 2024, I have the sections for the months. And it's pretty sparse because I've been over the last few months trying to figure out what do I want to use as my note-taking app. And I think I've settled on Heptabase after trying a handful of them. So yeah, there's each card is a weekly review with the dates and meaningful moments and then the notes that I've gathered for that week that I want to think about, chew on, you know, that kind of stuff, or I just want to keep and refer back to later when the time comes. All right, so again, this is a picture of the map and how I've designed my map, and hopefully it inspires you and encourages you. If you have any ideas or thoughts, I'd love to hear from you. Let me know in the comments, and I hope to see you next time.